Barney. We make money the old-fashioned way. We earn it. The Tulsa World. And by the Williams Company.
Good evening and welcome to our first edition of the 1994 Inside Tulsa Football with head coach Dave Rader. I'm Bill Landa, glad to be back with you again. As Coach Rader starts his seventh season, folks, as the University of Tulsa head football coach, it all gets happening on Saturday night at Missouri, Coach, and I know everybody's fired up about it.
We're very much looking forward to it, and the 6 years go by quickly, and it's good to be back with you again doing the show and reviewing TU football. It's great to be back on TCI and having our good sponsors with us. Out on our field of practice, the anticipation level is high and the enthusiasm is outstanding. I think our guys are really looking forward to playing someone other than each other. And our practice is indicative of that, Bill. The guys just really looks like they're looking forward to playing.
Well, we look forward tonight to giving you a preview of the 94 team and take a look at all the numbers as far as offense and defense. Also, of course, an in-depth look at the University of Missouri, what to expect on Saturday from the Tigers, and a chance to find out a little bit more about two-a-day practices. Mm-hmm. And thank goodness for everybody, those are now done.
I think everybody's glad they're over with. Our legs were weary, our backs were a little sore, and we're kind of cranky, and I think the players were tired, too. So it was time to take a little break there. We let him go home for a little bit and kind of rest up, get ready for school. Classes are here, and a lot of distractions this week. So we need to let our legs come back.
Certainly, winning football games is very important. But anyone will tell you that all these kids are at school to graduate, and that gets us to one of our new sponsors, Smith Barney. And we've decided we'll name it the Smith Barney Old Fashioned mm-hmm. Award, talking about scholar and student athletes, because you graduated a number of football players mm-hmm. last spring, and we have a look at some of those that we figured we'd start it off with that on this evening's show.
Right, Katrina is one of our managers last year. That looks like Cap Crowder, but that was what we was talking about, Bill. We'll have an award each week sponsored by Smith Barney. We'll just call it the old-fashioned award. Maybe a guy that you read about in the paper. Most likely will not be. It'll be somebody that earned it. There's Matt Federico with his mechanical engineering degree, working in Tulsa now. That looks like soup bone to me. What a story that was. Lamont Head, guys coming through. This is great to see these guys come through and get their degrees.
Well, and certainly when you show players highlight films, you want to include this on the tape when you recruit people.
You have to. This is what they came to school to receive, was their degree. They worked very hard for it. Kevin Seamster is back down in Houston working now. I saw James Bailey, who is coaching down in Houston now. You have to really feel good. Jeff McAnallen, there's Gus Farad, of course. Gus, with his degree at the Washington Redskins, performing very well. And, you know, what a relief it is for him that he goes to camp with his degree, and not very many guys do that anymore. You have to really compliment him on the work that he has done and is doing right now. It looks like Mark Lasky, Dennis Hickey. Right there, Dennis is now a coach down at Blinn Junior College. Lou Spanos is coaching, I believe, somewhere up in the Pittsburgh area. I believe that was Phil Natowski behind him. I think Phil's going to do some coaching, too, and teaching. So it was a fine class, and those guys did an awful lot for our program. But again, when you come to the University of Tulsa, you better dig in and work not only on the gridiron, but you get in the classroom, you're going to be severely challenged there. And I think our guys respond very well to that, and they hang in there and they get their degrees.
Well, that's the important thing, and I think so often people talk about the quality of education at the University of Tulsa. It ought to mean a little bit more when you graduated from a school like TU.
Well, I know it's going to mean a lot more to the guys who go through it because they know exactly how tough it is. I know that. And, you know, right now, with the way things are throughout the country, you know, Tulsa's rebounding a little bit, but so many of them like Tulsa so much and they don't want to stay here. And, you know, our job market just really in the past couple of years hasn't been that outstanding. And we like to see Tulsa grow.
Simmer sealed for simmered for hours flavor.
We see them go all over the country to work. We had word the other day, a captain of one of our teams, and the past years is now on the bobsled team, United States bobsled team. So even they do all sorts of things.
Well, we didn't see that in the press guide, did we? Interesting training for that. Stick around. We'll come back. We'll take a look at what returns for the University of Tulsa and how the lineup stacks up. Stay with us on Inside TU Football with head coach Dave Rader.
And it is intercepted. Look out. Off to the races is Mike Hensel, and nobody's going to catch him.
Hey, thank goodness for the Arby's Melt with Cheddar Sandwich, just 99 cents every day, loaded with slow-roasted roast beef.
Welcome back to Inside Tulsa Football with head coach Dave Rader. The Golden Hurricane to kick off Saturday night at Columbia, Missouri against the Missouri Tigers. And Dave, no better way, and this show certainly affords us the opportunity to take a look at your team than to just go position by position.
That'd be a great way
and
to
we'll
do.
Start with the defense tonight.
Our defense has been working extremely hard. We're have to have some guys up front lead the way. Sally Fu is going to have to continue with his pass rush expertise. He's excellent at that. And then supplement it with good run technique. He's doing an outstanding job for us. Justin Rich, of course, out of Okmulgee, has come along. He's one of the redshirt freshmen we keep talking about. That has to come along and play very well for us, and he's had a pretty good camp. Bo Deschereaux, whose brother played here for us in the mid-'80s, another redshirt freshman come along. He's put on weight, and he can be a good ball player for us. Lance Sloan is one of our leaders out of Cypress Creek in Houston. Just playing the nose tackle position, the defensive tackle position very well. You'll see Lance quite often. You hear his name over the radio. Mark Haberfield continues to improve inside for us, has bounced back from an automobile accident this summer, and has come on strong. Craig Arthur, very much a pleasant addition from NEO, coming to play a defensive tackle for us out of Sepulpa High School via NEO, and has really played well for us this fall. Corey Lax, of course, is one of our leaders. Playing the defensive tackle spot and coming off a broken ankle from last year. Corey will have to play very well for us. Hank Schaffer is now back in practice with us after hurting his hamstring out of Kingwood, Texas. And Hank will have to play extremely well for us. And that position up front will be critical in the Missouri game. Out of Sugarland, Cedric Clark, another young man that's coming off an injury. We expect great things from Cedric, and he's going to have to play very well for us. Shauna Boyle has come along very well for us at the defensive end position. Shauna, another young redshirt freshman out of Midwest City, plays football with a lot of heart. John Peters out of Cashel Hall in Tulsa is starting for us, the weak side linebacker, a very heady player, makes a lot of plays for us. Chris Fowler has come along very nice this two-a-day. We've never seen Chris play as well as he has in the last 2 weeks. He's out of Millwood High School, home with Joe Carter, of course. Majavita Kazadi is the middle linebacker that we think we need right now. He has come along very, very well, playing the position like a middle linebacker. He's thinking like a middle linebacker. He's going to have to play very well for us. Backed up by Randall Parsons, a young man from Tulsa East Central, who's progressed very nice. Floyd Good, a leader for us. At the strong side linebacker out of Booker T. Washington High School. Florida had to have an outstanding year for us. Backed up by Andrew Bates out of Clute, Texas, and Brazos Wood High School. Playing his best football we've seen him play at the strong side linebacker position. Now, one of our strongest points, I think, on our team is our secondary, led by Mike Hensel, a senior strong safety for us. Of course, we saw his big interception versus Houston a while ago. He'll have to make big plays for us again. Kelly Houston continues to come along, very strong for us at the strong safety position. He can play strong or free. Malcolm Williams is an addition at a Hines Junior College that has just played very well for us in the spring, made an outstanding play in practice the other day. We're just so glad that Malcolm is with us. Jason Jacoby, young man out of UConn, playing very well for us at corner. You'll probably see him on some kick returns and things like that also. He's come along very nicely. Pat D'Onofrio out of Sac City Junior College or community college in Sacramento. Now in his second year with us, playing very well at the corner, making more good decisions over and over again. Brian Self, the converted quarterback from Norman High, is being the defensive back that we thought he was going to be. At the free safety position, Terrence Joseph continues to make outstanding hits from that position. I think you'll hear his name quite often. Again, another youngster out of Midwest City. And then for Manford is Jeremy Bunch, who can play corner, safety, a variety of positions back there. And Jeremy's been doing very well this fall. Our punter, Mark DeLozier, has to have a great year. It can't be good. It has to be great. He has to continue to put the ball inside the 20 when need be. He can't have any come off the side of his foot. He has to be the steady performer that we need for our team.
Does this defense have a trademark or a personality of its own that you think has developed in 2 days?
I don't think there's any question. I think our defensive speed is better than any team that I've had since I've been here. And I think our guys run the football as well as any of them we've had. I think that what you'll see when you come out and watch them play, again, a bunch of youngsters will be playing for us, and when the ball takes off, we'll have 11 gold hats chasing it down as fast as they can. Now, we may not be all that big, but I tell you what, we're going to grab on a leg and hang on because we know help's coming. I think that's what you see, an intense, competitive unit there that will run to the football, and you'll just notice they'll be flying around everywhere.
All right, that's a look at the defensive side of things. We'll be back with a look at the other side of the football and the TU offense in just a moment.
Back to pass, Barat sets up, deep drop, a screen over the middle, complete to White, 35, 30, first down TU, down to the 25, breaks a tackle, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown TU!
TCI's got one.
Play ball!
Saturday night, September 3rd at 10 o'clock, TCI Channel 9 is your place for the Golden Hurricane at Missouri. TU football. Great hits, great runs, and the strikes go for touchdowns. Saturday night at 10 on Channel 9.
Don't forget that University of Tulsa home opener is a week from Saturday against now the University of Memphis, and going to be an exciting game out at Skelly Stadium on that one. We're talking offense now after taking a look at the defensive side of things, and a lot of firepower gone from last year with Gus Frerotte, Chris Penn now in the pros, and here's how you stack up starting with your split ends.
Wes Caswell is an exciting performer out of Tulsa Edison. Very quick, excellent hands, has had an excellent preseason, dodged a bullet the other day when he stepped on a sprinkler head. Jeff Futter, of course, took a tremendous blow in our scrimmage and has had a hard time getting back to practice, and we hope to get him up there. And if he's not full speed, then we won't take him up there. We'll make sure that he's ready to go. Justin Heineke has to be one of our leaders up front. A senior out of Edmond via NEO, playing extremely well right now, consistent with his decisions. Michael Rule is one of our big redshirt freshmen who gets better every day out there. We don't have enough reps for him. We can get 3,000 a day, and these youngsters need more. Michael's going to be a good player. Now, Brian Underwood, out of Edmonton, Alberta, is playing the best football we've ever seen him play. His consistency has been on a high level, playing very well for us. Another youngster out of Sepulpa is Jay Clark, who has worked extremely hard over the summer, had a lot of things to overcome, and is playing the best football we've seen him play since he's come to the University of Tulsa. David Millweed is a candidate for all-star accolades at the center position. He's a very good center. Brad Smith is backing him up, another redshirt freshman, and Brad gets better every day out there. He's out of Westmore in Moore, Oklahoma. Brian Noonan out of Stroud, all the people down in Lincoln County should be proud of Brian. He's coming here, added weight, and a very strong youngster, playing at the strong guard position. He's very impressive there right now. Jason Sanders has moved in from tackle to the strong guard position and provides us with excellent backup and can play actually quite a few positions. We move out to the tackle position. Doug Pasula back to start his second year. Even stronger than he was last year out of Mount Pleasant, PA. Doug has been progressing nicely, as has Drew Poston. Drew's really come a long way, put on a lot of weight, worked on his athletic ability, has more flexibility, playing very well right now at the strong tackle position. Now, Mark Lippe has come a long way since the spring, come back, and put on weight, kept his quickness, continues to catch the ball right now. He will start for us. Aaron Murray's been sidelined with a little bit of injury. If he doesn't go, then Nelson Van Wise will be our backup there at the tight end. Nelson, of course, out of Calgary. Aaron there out of Chicago. And Chris Anderson playing tight end out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
And we'll see you. And you guys use your tight ends. You go four deep.
There's Nelson. Nelson out of Calgary, Alberta. Of course, a big Stampeder fan. And has really this fall been more consistent than we've ever seen. At the quarterback position, Troy DeGar has progressed at a faster pace than I thought he would. He's been very consistent, making good decisions. He's out of Westbury High School in Houston. Tad Jones right now would go in after him. Young man out of Ulagom has come in and doing a very good job. Casey Bourne would be right behind Tad there, and those guys are going after the number two spot. Casey, of course, missed spring due to an injury out of Crescent, and he just keeps getting better. At the tailback's positions, maybe one of the strongest spots we have projected for our offensive team, Solomon White out of Dulles High School in Sugarland continues to excite us in practice, has excellent balance, good work habits. Kenny Gunn out of Cashel Hall, a shifty runner, excellent acceleration. Those two guys go neck and neck, and I can't tell you who's going to be in the game. We alternate them in there. Out of our fullback position is Jason Percy out of Holland Hall. I've been very steady through the fall practice, playing better than he ever has. Jason Bennett out of Metro Christian Academy in Tulsa. He's a converted wide receiver, and actually he's bigger than that right now and providing good play for us. Michael Kedzor at the flanker position at a Claremore. Continues to catch the ball very well. He's needs to work on his consistency some, but he's turned out to be an excellent player for us. Clay Martin, redshirt freshman out of Tulsa Hale, comes in. So many people saw him play basketball, and he's doing very well at the wide receiver position. James Anderson's our kicker right now. He went head to head with Brandon, and right now James continues to kick the ball very well, as does Brandon out of Booker T. Washington High School. We feel real good about our place kickers right now.
Coach, I don't know how many players we just looked at there, but through your two and three deep, in some cases four, mm-hmm. I think there were three seniors listed. Right. So you've got a real young football mm-hmm. team, but certainly one that is not void of talent.
Now, as we talk to our players, we're not really concerned about their age. In fact, we don't even bring it up, Bill. We talk about the thing that that I'm most concerned about on this team is not the size or the speed or the schedule or their age or anything like that. It's just, can we overcome adversity? Can we make things happen? And can we put all those things behind us? Because they are talented. They can play football. They're extremely well coached. We put them in positions, and we put them in a multitude of scrimmage plays. They're ready to play ball. So anything that they might use along the age deal is just a cop-out right now. They're ready to play, and they're good football players.
When you talk about well-coached, and you've got a staff that's been intact, and mm-hmm. sometimes I don't know if people right. realize how important that is, particularly from the head coach standpoint, to know that you've got the same group to work with again.
Well, we're just very fortunate to have the quality group of men that we have on our staff, and then to be together for the second consecutive year. This doesn't happen very often in college football anywhere. And then we're joined this year with by Chris Thurman coming back to on our staff. It's an extremely strong staff. Gets along very well. The exchange of ideas is outstanding, and you see each side of the ball helping each other. What makes a difficult situation for one side? Why is that happening? And we see these things going. So, very pleased with our staff. Can't say enough about them. They're fine men.
That was my Barry Switzer question. I wanted to make sure that you didn't just reach over here and punch me in the shoulder.
That won't happen on this show.
Coach, when you take a look at completing two-a-days, I know before the season started, you mentioned the strength of your running backs as maybe being the most important thing or the group that would stand out. Anything change in your mind, offensively or defensively, from the start of two-a-days to after that?
Well, I think some question spots that we had that are for sure strengthened. I think our linebacking position has exhibited strong, consistent play, and we're not near as concerned about them as we were going into it. These guys have stepped up the pace and put themselves in a position now to have an opportunity to be very successful there. They're the ones that put themselves in that position. I expect them to play very well. I think the quarterback position has strengthened itself, especially with Troy's play. We like that, and I think our wide receivers have come along. I think Michael Kedzor can prove to be a very good inside receiver, which for us is a key for our offense. I just think some guys that we asked to step up, pick up their pace, be more consistent, they've done that. That gives me encouragement, and now they have a great opportunity in front of them.
All right, hang with us. We've got more coming up after a quick preview there. We'll have a chance to talk a little more about the team as well as look ahead at the University of Missouri and talk about TU's affiliation with the WAC Conference. All straight ahead here on Inside Tulsa Football with head coach Dave Rader.
As blitzes on, Farratt throws the ball downfield. Kedzior wide open, catches it at the goal line. Touchdown, Tulsa!
The most valuable investment you'll ever make isn't a stock or a bond. It's a relationship. With a Smith Barney financial consultant who pays attention to your financial well-being, who takes the time to understand who you are and helps you plan for all the milestones of your life. If your portfolio isn't getting this kind of attention, talk with us. Smith Barney. We make money the old-fashioned way. We earn it.
Ever since Southwest Airlines introduced Friends Fly Free, people have gotten friendlier.
Sugar Plum, your favorite pillow.
If you make reservations and buy your round-trip ticket at our regular low, unrestricted fare, a friend gets to fly with you, free.
Hey, Dad, seen the hedge trimmer?
There's no advance purchase and tickets are fully refundable.
Here's that putter I borrowed last year, old buddy.
Southwest Airlines Friends Fly Free. It's great for your pocketbook and your popularity.
Where in the world can you find out about Cowboys and Indians, Touchbacks and Razorbacks, Slams and Rams, Sooners and Laters? Every day in the world's expanded sports section. Because nothing covers more of your world than your world. Where in the world can you find out what's up and what's down? Who's being taken over and who's being overtaken? In the world's expanded business section every day. Because nothing covers more of your world than your world.
Welcome back to Inside Tulsa Football with head coach Dave Rader. About a week ago Saturday, University of Tulsa had a night scrimmage. I guess you've had one other since then, but that was kind of a dress rehearsal, Dave. And
it was.
Money going to the Rick Scott Trust Fund. A fun night, a night you guys got a chance to learn a lot about your football team.
It was a beautiful evening, and we were anxious for the opportunity as a team, you know, to help Rick out. It was kind of a community type event, and we raised a few dollars for Rick's fund, and I think everybody, I didn't hear anybody complain. Our team, you know, got to help out in a charity cause, and they got to exhibit their skills. That looked like my dad coming there, to tell you the truth. And it was just a nice evening there. It looks like Coach Rex Trent from Claremore Sequoia right there, Tim Martin's coach, coming in.
Well, kind of a new tradition for TU fans come out, get a little feel for what's going on, get to see your old friends.
Clay Martin's mother right there, Sharon Martin, getting to see her son play the first time. We had a beautiful evening there, and we started off, and Horton makes a nice throw to West right there. And I think through the evening, it was ebb and flow, which was good. The offense had some good things happen, and the defense had some good things happen. Nice throw by Troy again. And this is what we want to see at our scrimmage. We had to turn the guys loose. We had to go full speed and bring him down tackling. Again, another fine play by Malcolm Williams right there. He is good on the pass coverage. He's good on the run support. You're really going to like Malcolm Williams. Again, another fine throw by Troy there. I think that all the people that were out enjoyed the evening. We got such positive feedback from the evening. Tad Jones is in there at quarterback now. During the scrimmage, you got to see that, like, the guys like Reggie Williams there running with the football. Young freshman here, Cedric Clark, signing some autographs after the game. I think our players like that, and all the kids on the field seem to enjoy that. Wes Caswell signing a jacket there by that youngster. These are the things to me that, boy, growing up in Tulsa, as I did, these are great things to do. But let me look at that young man's face right there. You don't think he's enjoying Wes Caswell writing on his back. Troy DeGar signing autographs. And we had a bunch of youngsters out there and just seemed to enjoy the time. And I know our players enjoyed it.
Well, and also helps develop lifelong football fans for the University of Tulsa, regardless of where those youngsters end up living.
And I know we don't have Mark. There's Pat D'Onofrio there. And there's Kendall, our daughter, right there on the right. And we're signing some. There's her cousin Jake right there.
She's not selling your autographs yet, is she?
No, she's wondering what all is going on. But you're right. This, you know, I want our people, I want the people of Tulsa to feel, you know, this is your team. And I understand that you may have another favorite school or something, but in Tulsa, you've got to like the University of Tulsa. You have to like what we stand for. We do it, as a private school. We haven't been able to do it with the television monies, things like that. Yet we continue to turn out the quality product. We turn out quality people. I'm not saying we have everybody's involved in the choir on our team, but again, we continue to graduate them. You can bring your children to our practice. You don't have to worry about the languages out there. You don't have to worry about the way our guys are going to treat you with disrespect when coming off the field. We need this. We need young people to feel positive about playing a great game of football. We need to people in our community feel positive about coming to the University of Tulsa and supporting our program. So it was just a good night, and things turned out well, and I'm thankful for everybody that showed up that night.
And you said before the season, or before the practice session started, Dave, you were really concerned about just keeping this team healthy. For most teams, that's the number one factor. Has it turned out that way?
Right. We've had a lot of nagging injuries, had some hamstrings and things like that. But like I said, we dodged a big bullet with John Lane getting hit on the back of the knee and Wes Caswell coming down on the side of a sprinkler. So far, it looks like everybody's going to be healthy going into the game. I feel good that everybody's going to be at 100% Saturday night. That is a definite positive for us. You hear coaches, and you're hearing it right now throughout the country, saying our depth is a problem. You know, we've got to keep everybody healthy, and you do. And I think that our guys want everybody to play. Man, when we rotate people in and out, it's none of this, well, why is he in, and things like that. It's, you know, it's your chance. You go make it happen, and that's the way we conduct our games and practices. But we have to have those same guys playing over and over again. It gives us continuity, it gives us consistency, and it keeps the morale up of the team.
What position are you the deepest at, that if you do have an injury that you might be able to plug another guy or two in there, not feel you're going to drop off much?
Pleasingly enough, right now we're looking at our defensive line. It's going to be, we have a chance here, if Cornelius Butler comes back pretty soon, that we could go three deep all across the defensive line, which is kind of unheard of here at the University of Tulsa. Boy, if we're going to stop the run this year, we'll have to be strong up front. I'm excited about that prospect.
We want to remind you, and first of all, thank all of you that came out to the scrimmage a week ago Saturday and contributed so generously toward the Rick Scott Trust Fund. If you didn't make that or you haven't heard of his story, it's pretty well documented. Rick is a guy who's worked for many years on this show as a cameraman, and over the years as a freelance cameraman whose wife and son were killed in a horrific auto accident in January. Rick's immobilized right now, has made tremendous progress, though, and will be back on the job soon as far as his role as an executive producer of the Jimmy Houston Fishing Show. But there are mounting medical costs that will continue. We've raised, I think, over $40,000 now, and a lot of you to be thanked for that. There is the address if you want to contribute, and we will have future events coming up. We certainly thank the University of Tulsa for all their support, Dave.
You bet. Rick, we miss you tonight. This is my first show without him here. You know, you talk about this is our seventh year, so I know he's watching, and we miss you here, and hope things are going well, and be anxious to see you soon, and come on out to the ball game. Now, I'm not guaranteeing you got a free ticket. You got to talk to Bill about that.
We'll do that. We'll sneak in that gate. Dave's kids have told me how to get in there. They bring all their classmates. I want to remind you what else is going on at University of Tulsa sports-wise. So as we take a break, take a look at the TU sports calendar.
Can you find 500,000 people in one place at one time? Your World Trade Center, the World Classifieds, where more people will see what you have to sell, because nothing covers more of your world than your world. Where in the world can you find out about Cowboys and Indians, Touchbacks and Razorbacks, Slams and Rams, Sooners and Laters? Every day in the world's expanded sports section, because nothing covers more of your world than your world.
This label tells you it's 100% cotton. This label tells you it's 100% real cheese. And this label tells you it's 100% low fares. Always check the label. Southwest, the low fare airline. Southwest Airlines wrote the book on low fares. And it's available in paperback. For low fares to more places more often, fly Southwest, the low fare airline.
That old baseball strike got you down? Haven't seen a ball game in weeks? Want to see one? TCI's got one.
Play ball!
Saturday night, September 3rd at 10 o'clock, TCI Channel 9 is your place for the Golden Hurricane at Missouri. TU football. Great hits, great runs, and the strikes go for touchdowns. Saturday night at 10 on Channel 9.
We'll get into the season ticket plan here in just a minute, but one thing that will help lead us into that that I think is generating a lot of excitement at the University of Tulsa, Dave, is something we haven't had a chance to talk about, and that's the Western Athletic Conference affiliation that TU and some others have joined up with, and things are already shaping up for 1996.
Sure are. It'll be here quickly. It's just that I think our people and our community needs to understand we can't wait till 1996. Our program is... Very much the backbone is season tickets, and we need to bust into 1996 full speed ahead. We don't need to, you know, sit here and wait for it to come around and then try to get something going. So the season tickets need to be bought this year. They need to be bought next year. I'm asking you not just to sit around, because there's many many needs that we have in our program. And I'm not just talking about football, because football helps every program that we have in our athletic department. So if you're wanting to help volleyball, if you're wanting to help any tennis or any other sports that we have, season ticket sales helps everybody there. But for sure, if you want to help football and you want to help us get into the WAC in 2 years and have our program going full speed ahead, then I'm asking you for to set your sights on the WAC now and buy the tickets now. I really need you to do that. There's so many things that we need to get done. Right now, I'm asking you to help us push on through. I need to feel the push. We need to see it financially, and our kids deserve you to be at the game, because anytime you come to Skelly Stadium, it's a great evening. You're going to see outstanding football. Doesn't matter who shows up. Tell you what, University of Tulsa will, and our kids will play lights out.
Let's give you a further look at what you can expect as far as tickets are concerned and the price range we're talking about. You see the season tickets in side gold, side blue, and end zone. Side gold is between the 15 and 15, $16 on a single game basis. Side blue is outside of the 15. And then the end zone tickets, $30 for a season ticket, $6 for a single. The PFFZ is, no, it's not a frequent flyer award, but certainly it's the Pizzetti's fan,
come on,
family fun zone. Thank if you. I can spit it out. $100 is what I'm trying to tell you for a family of five. You're not going to find a better deal. No. And usually some of your rowdier fans, and I know your team really aligns with that group in the end zone.
Hey, I mean, they love to score in any end zone. You know, the north end zone gets rowdy, and they have their own. But, you know, the south end zone is where they can almost touch the fans, because it comes right down onto the field, and the kids are having a great time. I just don't see how a family can find a better value. If you're trying to do something that the whole unit can do together and do it for five Saturdays or four of them in the evening, you won't find a better value than the Pizzetti's Family Fun Zone. It should sell out instantly. If you want to do anything at all with your family, and they all enjoy.
Well, certainly want to remind people, we're talking about the WAC. There's three Western Athletic Conference teams that are on the schedule this year. And looking down the road, the WAC, there's talk that the WAC champion could end up meeting in the Cotton Bowl sometimes. So there's so many good things going on at the University of Tulsa football. What's your thoughts on the state of college football and how TU fits into that?
The state of college football is, I think, right now doing very well. You just won't see many additions in the next few years. If anything happens, then we'll lose more scholarships probably. I'm a little concerned about how the TV revenue has been distributed. It seems like the few is getting more. The few are getting more. I just wonder how that's going to shape out. I think the talent level is as high as it's ever been. I think it's an outstanding game. I'm just a little hesitant right now to see what's going to happen with the revenue sharing the way it's going. And if the bigs get bigger and the mediums become smaller, then we may have some problems later on in there. So we'll see how it goes, but I think we're doing okay right now.
Well, one of the things the WAC seems to have going for it is strength in numbers, and in particularly having decided already in a quadrant format where Tulsa's in with the other three new members from Texas, with TCU, SMU, and the Rice Owls, playing those schools every year, and then going against another quadrant every year, fans are going to get a chance to have a diversity in their schedule, but still some uniformity to it.
And that's really progressive thinking, to divide the league up that way. And then we'll have teams from all over the western part of the United States coming to the University of Tulsa. This is going to give our community outstanding exposure west. You know, our scores will be always in the WAC score box, and people and publications throughout the country put it in there. And it is going to be nothing but good for us. I've told you this many times. I wish we could do it this year. But I think by playing the three WAC schools this year on this year's schedule gives us a good way to break into the league. We'll get a real good feel of what's going on in the WAC conference. And I think they'll get a good feel for us. I'm looking forward to playing them. But I tell you what, it's still quite a ways down the road. We have so many things we have to get accomplished in the meantime. and I don't want to take anything away from our preparation for our game this week. The most important game on our schedule this year is the next game. The next game is Missouri. And our guys are going to prepare totally for that. And when those other games come up, they'll be ready for them too.
And I know you look forward to giving Dave all your suggestions. Normally you have that opportunity on this show with calls. They will be in future programs. Tonight's program is a show that is taped, but we want to remind you, I have a chance to visit with Dave on a regular basis. Next week's show is on a Tuesday night, and then we're always on Monday nights. But every week on the radio, you can visit with the coach. Charleston Bay Restaurant is a location. Come on out and support TU football and have a chance to meet Dave and many of the fine folks in University of Tulsa. That's at 61st and Sheridan on Wednesday nights. Bruce Howard will be your host from 7 to 8 p.m. It's live on AM 1430 KQLL. And I know you're looking forward to the new location there and a chance to visit one-on-one with a lot of the fans.
We sure are. Of course, I enjoy talking with our fans, and the more phone calls, the better. I'd like to talk about our program and the things that are going on. I think the location is just outstanding. The people there are very excited about us coming in. Get ready. When you can't call in here live on TV, you hang around to Wednesday, and we take so many more phone calls, and we have a great time on that. But one thing that we try to do at the University of Tulsa in our athletic department is make sure we keep open lines of communication with our fans and the community, because I want to hear how you're thinking. I want you to hear how I'm thinking, and hopefully this all works out that we get ever-growing numbers of support in the fine city of Tulsa. So we open it up. Not too many schools do it this way. Not too many coaches open up this much, so I want you to make sure you take advantage of it.
All right. Take it easy on him. Hasn't started yet either. Speaking of take it easy, two-a-day practices, which you all know are such a breeze. Well, Mike Davis will have a look at that when we come back. Our producer extraordinaire had a chance to go out and visit and find out what it was really like. Stay with us.
The most valuable investment you'll ever make isn't a stock or a bond. It's a relationship with a Smith Barney financial consultant who pays attention to your financial well-being, who takes the time to understand who you are and helps you plan for all the milestones of your life. If your portfolio isn't getting this kind of attention, talk with us. Smith Barney. We make money the old-fashioned way. We earn it.
From head to toe, Pacific Care has families covered. With Pacific Care, you can choose a primary care doctor plus an obstetrician and a pediatrician for your growing family. When it comes to your family's health, choose the plan that covers more. Pacific Care, healthcare for the way you live.
In sports is found here. HSE, bringing you all the rim-shaking slams from the nation's number one college hoop hunter. The Big 8, the best in sports is found here. Dallas Mavericks basketball, taking on the NBA's top team. And Texas Rangers baseball, their ball-pounding offensive assault is armed and dangerous. The best in sports is found here, and it's available on cable. HSE, call your local cable operator today.
Welcome back to Inside Tulsa Football with Head Coach Dave Rader as we get ready to open things up. University of Tulsa against Missouri on Saturday. Two-a-day practices. A lot is said about two-a-days, Dave. They're just kind of a necessary evil, aren't they?
Well, we're granted so many practice opportunities before the first game by the NCAA rules. So depending on when your school starts in relationship with your first game, does it dictate how many two-a-day practices you have? Because if there's no school and there's no game that week, then each day counts as 2 days, so you have to use them. We're one of the few schools that has 2 weeks full of two-a-days. Our guys work extremely hard. We don't have to go anywhere to do them. We do them right on our campus. And it is a lot of tough work because it's not like the pros where you can, well, we'll take this day off because we'll make it up some other time. It just doesn't work that way. You have these many days, you get after it, and it's tough, and it's hard work. And I tell you what, our guys attack it as well as any group I've ever been around.
And Mike Davis has his feature look at two-a-day practices out at the University of Tulsa. I imagine the players watch that and they think, well, boy, it didn't seem that mellow out on the field, did it, Dave?
Yeah, I didn't hear one violin out there the whole time. Some of them heard some whistles and some bells, I know that, but it was, I never heard that. I tell you what, Mike is great at making, it was just another picnic out there, wasn't it? Wasn't anything to it. Nice piece of work.
All right. You know, when you take a look at... All right, he says, Bill, shut up and go to the break. Mike, you're the boss, okay? We'll be back. Talk about Missouri in just a minute.
Many men have dreamed of being sent in by the coach to win the game. In reality, it can be tough out there, and injuries do occur. If you're unfortunate enough to experience an injury, make sure you're fully recovered before you get back into the game. If you don't, you could find yourself at the bottom of the heap without a leg to stand on. Everyone loves a hero, so take care and be one. This message brought to you by the Eastern Oklahoma Orthopedic Center.
Hey, thank goodness for the Arby's Melt with Cheddar Sandwich, just 99 cents every day, loaded with slow-roasted roast beef. The Arby's Melt comes with a thick, velvety blanket of tangy melted cheddar, just 99 cents every day. Ouch! The Arby's Melt with Cheddar, just one of your favorites on Arby's 99-cent value menu.
That old baseball strike got you down? Haven't seen a ball game in weeks? Want to see one? TCI's got one.
Play ball!
Saturday night, September 3rd at 10 o'clock, TCI Channel 9 is your place for the Golden Hurricane at Missouri. TU football. Great hits, great runs, and the strikes go for touchdowns. Saturday night at 10 on Channel 9.
Understand that Mike Davis, as great a producer as he is, he's still a big baseball fan, and he's got to be weaned off of it as they continue to strike. Thus, the baseball music is interweaved into the football show, right? We are playing football this Saturday.
There's no doubt about it. And man, isn't it great that football season's here.
Well, going to be fun to open up the University of Missouri. Larry Smith, the new head coach up there, a guy who's done a lot at USC as well as Arizona and Tulane, a year out of coaching. When you take a look at guys have had that sabbatical, you expect much change from him or the same Larry Smith?
Well, I think we'll get the same Larry Smith, one who's fundamentally sound, continues to put out good teams, is not, from what we understand, you know, a real wild guy when it comes to offensive and defensive schemes. His players will play hard. I think that's what you'll see. I think it's been his formula for success at Tulane, Arizona, and Southern Cal. We expect a formidable challenge. You know, of course, we'll be underdogs going into the game once again, which is right where we want to be. Our kids will be extremely excited about playing. I hope that we play with a deep, deep sense of enthusiasm and not a high level of emotion, because that emotion can make you do strange things, but the enthusiasm just makes you want to play football even more. I'm hoping our guys are working towards being a football player and not just going out and playing football.
Well, this team, Jeff Handy is a guy who could throw it all over the yard, and apparently they're going to go more to a run-type offense this year, so you really have to be prepared for a little bit of everything.
I think so, and we don't really know a whole lot about them because they won't let us into their practices, and there's no videotape to go off of.
Well, that's no good.
I know. Can you?
I know these
that?
WAC teams will cooperate.
I'm sure they will. But the little tailback Freeman is a good player, the big Washington at the fullback position. Of course, Handy can throw it very well. I think they'll come out with a nice scheme offensively. We hope that we can figure it out fairly fast. Defensively, they're going to revolve around the two inside linebackers who are good football players. That's about all we know about their personnel. Their schemes, we'll find out, I guess, when we trot out there.
All right, the games, of course, as usual, all heard on the radio live, and Bruce Howard, as well as Rick Corey and J.V. Haney, are your broadcasters this year. You can follow them here in Tulsa on All Sports AM 1430, and that contest,
if you tune in at 7:30
start.
If you tune in at 7:30, you missed an hour.
Yeah, TU will be up about 14 zip. So if you want to hear the first couple of touchdowns, I suggest you catch 6:30, maybe a little bit before for the pregame show. And then the game, of course, TU in Missouri, Saturday night, 10 p.m. on Channel 9. That'll be on a tape delay basis, obviously. And look forward to Steve August joining me for the telecast there. And then Tulsa for the home opener, University of Memphis against University of Tulsa, Saturday night, a week from Saturday at Skelly Stadium.
Right. We have the home opener, of course, to be our second game. I think we have quite a few fans going up to the Missouri game. We'll leave as a team by a charter around 4 o'clock on Friday afternoon, get a brief workout underneath the portable lights that they're bringing in Friday night, then get up, go back over to the stadium after breakfast Saturday morning, get a light workout, and then get ready to play Saturday night. So we'll be here before you know it.
All right, Coach, good luck. We'll have a chance to talk about it next Tuesday night. We hope you have a chance to take in the ball game. Thanks for being with us on Inside TU Football.
Inside Tulsa Football is brought to you by The Williams Company, The Tulsa World, Smith Barney. We make money the old-fashioned way. We earn it. Southwest Airlines, the low-fare airline. Pacificare. When choosing a health plan, choose Pacificare. Mazzio's Pizza. Lexus of Tulsa, who invites you to test drive a Lexus today. Eastern Oklahoma Orthopedic Center. Bank of Oklahoma, where convenience is cornered. And by Arby's Roast Beef Restaurant.
Coach Raiders clothing by Harold, Tulsa, Oklahoma City, and Norman. Furnishings provided by Snow's Furniture.